Welcome to the Bella Books Author's Corner. My name is Karin Kallmaker, and I'm going to read to you from Unforgettable. When Unforgettable was first released many years ago, it had this cover, and the popular rumor at the time was that one of these pictures was me. But no. Now it has this lovely Lady in Blue cover that I adore. It fits the book so well. And the Lady in Blue on the cover is Rhett Jameson, the heroine of our story. It's called Unforgettable because it should make you think of the classic song. Now there's an unforgettable cheerleader in Rhett's past, and it's the only reason that she has gone home for her 25th high school reunion. However, instead of connecting with the cheerleader, she's reconnected with the class brain. Angel has a PhD now, and she and her research team at the university are on the verge of finding a cure for ovarian cancer. Now, Rhett sings blues and started performing right out of high school, and so she's never finished college. To say that she's feeling just a little bit intimidated is an understatement. Good God, she thought. Angel's friends will think I'm the empty-headed bimbo she keeps around for relaxation. Rhett flopped across the motel bed onto her side. Don't do this to yourself, she scolded. It's just your mother talking. You are not a bimbo. You are not a lightweight. So you don't know a genome from a gerbil. What the hell difference does that make? It's probably a fact that not one of Angel's friends knows every word to American Pie and can sing the entire song on pitch, a cappella. Maybe they have stared the mysteries of the universe in the face, but they have probably never cradled a couple of hundred people in the warmth of their voice and left their hearts and souls the lighter for it. There's nothing lightweight about that, she repeated. Just let go of your inferiority complex. Art is not more pure than science, and science is not more worthy than art. Art is why people want to live, and the desire to live is why Angel is trying to cure cancer. You need each other. So there. She sang the crap out of American Pie in the shower, just for good measure. Denton's Diner had always served awesome sandwiches. Rhett tossed his swimsuit and towel into the car and headed for Woden for a late lunch. After that, any beach at all was on her menu. Little time in the sun wouldn't hurt her. This was a vacation, after all. She stood at the door to the diner and grinned at her luck. Thank you, universe. She went inside and slid into the booth to face Angel. Hi. Angel was obviously startled, but Rhett didn't detect any displeasure. I was just coming in for a sandwich. Angel indicated her half-empty plate. They're still great. Pickles, too. I've decided you're right. About what? The waitress arrived to bring Angel a tall, frosty lemonade and to take Rhett's order. We had to make a new batch. Sorry it took so long. I'll have one of those too, Rhett said, and a Reuben. Angel waited until the waitress was out of earshot before asking, what am I right about? Slowing down. Oh, I'm right, am I? What kind of slowing down did you mean? The one you were talking about getting to know each other before. Angel was blushing. Rhett felt the knot in her stomach uncoil. Okay, Angel might be a genius, but she could still blush. You mean when we were walking in the water or later? The waitress set down a lemonade for Rhett and bustled away. Rhett knew her smile was devilish. Which one are you talking about? It's not possible to have a serious discussion here. Rhett bit the end off of the huge dill pickle wedge. It was so sour. The glands in her throat went gonzo. Were you being serious? About in the water or later, you know, when we got to the trees? Wipe that grin off your face, young lady. Angel tried and failed to be stern. We can't very well talk about whether we're going to... She dropped her voice so low, Rhett almost couldn't hear her. Well, you know what? Not while you're eating a pickle. Rhett could not help herself. What would you rather I was eating? Angel's fingers clenched on her lemonade, and Rhett had the feeling she barely escaped having the contents dumped on her head. We'll go for a walk, okay? Nothing serious until then. Red enjoyed a huge bite of the corned beef and sauerkraut when it was delivered. The sandwich was slathered in Thousand Island dressing and a dash of spicy mustard. It was as close to kosher as food got in these parts, which was not very. It sure is hot, but I think there's been enough rain for a good harvest this year. Angel said nothing. I was at the store the other day and I just couldn't believe the price of eggs. They've gone up and up. I think I'll have to give up custard at this rate. Angel glowered at her. She was very good at glowering. That expression probably stopped college freshmen in their tracks. Rhett was not a college freshman. Have you ever noticed that they can pass a law to make people pick up after their dogs, but they won't make people pick up after themselves? What's this world coming to? Angel had a white-knuckled grip on her knife when she said, "If you don't stop talking, I'm going to kill you." That knife isn't sharp enough. It is when you know precisely where to insert it. Rick grinned at her and ate in cheerful silence. The more she smiled at Angel, the more Angel frowned. The waitress dropped off the check and Rhett snapped it up. "I remember owing you for the, you know," Angel looked confused. "The accommodations?" "Oh, don't worry about that." As Angel passed her on the way to the front door, Rhett murmured, "You're adorable when you blush." Outside on the sidewalk, Angel burst out, "Would you stop being so goddamn charming?" She set off toward town at a pace that made Rhett breathless, and Angel had much shorter legs. She watched Angel's hinder. Her shorts fit so nicely, who wouldn't? Her tank top left her shoulders nearly bare. Lovely, lovely shoulders. "Now, Rhett," she admonished herself, "remember that you agreed it was time to slow down." And there you have it, Rhett and Angel's courtship. It's unexpectable and unexpectable. Yes, unexpected and unforgettable. Unexpectable. Okay, I'm going to leave that in. It's available from Bella Books, and you can go to their site, bellabooks.com, and search for Kallmaker. There's only one, and that is really for the best. You can also look for follow-up short stories involving several of the main characters from the novel in my Frosting on the Cake collections. Thank you for listening. Please stay safe. We will meet again, and soon we're going to know where and when.